Hey my friends, what's going on? I'm back with another video and today we are looking at an automated slider, the one from Smarta. Is that how you pronounce it? Yeah, well, I believe that's how you pronounce it. Now, I have been looking for an automated slider for quite some time now. Why? Because if you're a one-man show like I am, having things automated is really, really helpful. So I can speak to the camera while the slider can do its thing maybe in a bit of a distance. Also, if you're like me and YouTube is just your hobby or your side business, you don't have too much time to spend on creating these videos. So having something that really nails a shot in pretty much one go can be super, super helpful. I remember when I was working with my manual slider, it took me sometimes 4, 5, 6 attempts for me to nail that shot. And that is very, very time consuming. So a little automated slider like this that nails the shot in the first attempt can be great. Now here you go, this is the box the slider comes with and I have to say I'm loving it. I'm a very big fan of very simple and straightforward designs and this one here just looks great. Now let's have a quick look what the slider comes with. It is not much but all you need is actually included. So let's open up the box and let's have a quick look inside. Now inside we are greeted by probably the simplest user manual I've ever seen. It's almost comical and hopefully it is really not necessary to include even more because the slider is so easy to operate. And underneath we see the warranty cards and then we have all the accessories and cables that the manufacturer included. Now first we have the USB charging cable and thanks for this to be USB-C, and then we have the camera shutter release cables, two types for Canon cameras and then for the manufacturer that I'm shooting with, Sony. Other than that, it's really just the slider itself, which in my opinion looks gorgeous, a very simple, straightforward unibody design which I love, and then the manufacturer also included a release plate for mounting the camera. Now this is essentially what the slider comes with, I mean this and the release cables, but a very simple camera mount, and I thought once the camera is mounted on top of the slider, it's very limiting in terms of the direction and the levels, you know, that you can achieve with this. So what I thought, it's easier to get one of these Z-shaped, you know, flex heads, very easy to work with. You have on this side dampening knobs in order to make it a bit more smoother. On the other side, fixing knobs. So if you have a heavy camera with a heavy lens, it's really secure and your gear is being taken care of. But essentially with this Z-shaped flex head, you can achieve all kinds of different directions and I'm really loving it. And I'll leave a link in the description below. So if you're interested, you can pick one up yourself. Now, as I said earlier, the slider with its straightforward, simple unibody design looks great. But let's have a look at the technical specifications as well. The length of the slider, as in the camera travel, is 8 inches, which is slightly over 20 centimeters. The manufacturer says that it probably covers 95% of your shooting needs, and I have to admit this is kind of true. When I use my much longer manual slider, I still just use only 10-12 seconds of the actual video. Hence, if you're a bit more careful with how you set up your shot, this little slider should really cover pretty much all your shooting needs. For horizontal movements, the payload of this little guy is an impressive 15 kilos. I'm really not sure with what type of cameras you're shooting, but with 15 kilos, it'll be hard to push this little slider to its limits. For incline shots, the payload drops quickly and quite significantly, down to 1 kilogram if you're using it on a 90 degree angle, so be a bit careful with that. The built-in 1500 mAh battery should last about 48 hours in normal use, which means if you're shooting outside, in the field, this is a great little companion. Talking about shooting outside and being a great little companion, the slider here travels extremely well. In terms of weight, we are looking at roughly half a kilogram, 569 grams to be exact, and the dimensions are 262 mm in length, 62 millimeters width and 22 millimeters in height, which means this little slider should really fit in any backpack. Now let's have a quick look how to operate the slider, which is really, really easy. Now first of all, as you can see at the top, we have two sides, left and right. And the only thing that you have to worry about is how to send the camera from one side to the other. At the front, we see the jack for the shutter release cable. We talk about this in just a second, and then the USB-C jack for charging the slider. To the side of the slider, you'll find the on and off button that also serves as the manual control button. Long press to turn the slider on, and the four LEDs that appear indicate the charge level of the battery. From there on, operating the slider couldn't be easier. Double press to send it from left to right, triple press from right to left, and a quadruple press to reset it to its center position. Operating the slider mini with your smartphone is also ridiculously easy. As a matter of fact, if you turn on the slider and launch the app on your smartphone, you don't even have to pair, they just find each other and you're ready to go. The wheel type control at the center allows you to set the speed of the slider. As you can see, 100% is 20 seconds from one side to the other. 1% would be around 33 minutes from one side to the other. Below you see the current position of the slider, and then at the bottom, simple left and right arrows to operate the slider mini. It really is that easy to operate the slider mini. The manufacturer, Smarter, couldn't have made it any simpler. It is really fantastic to work with the slider mini that way. A tab at the upper left corner gives you two controls. First of all, you can turn off the alert sounds, which in my opinion are very annoying, so I'm happily doing that. And then you can turn on and off auto mode, which means the slider would start and stop recording when you're operating the slider. At the upper right corner, you find the advanced modes. First of all, we have time-lapse mode, second, stop motion, and the newly introduced loop mode functionality as well. In the time-lapse mode, you can choose the interval, the play time and the recording time, the frame rate, and in which direction you send the slider mini. And then with the release cable, the slider mini would take control over your camera and do the rest all by itself, which is absolutely fantastic. Smarter has created a variety of different templates for different shooting scenarios, again, which makes it absolutely easy. And if you want, you can even create new ones and add to the list that's already there. Next, let's have a look at how to use the Smarter Mini for stop motion animation. Let's go back, tap on stop motion, and first of all, you want to set how many frames you want to shoot. Once you're all set, you tap on next, and then with the tap on the red button, you can start shooting your stop motion animation. Every time you take a frame, the slider mini would just move a tiny bit in the direction that you set earlier. It takes a very long time, so I'm not demonstrating it obviously, so let's go back. The last feature is loop mode, which essentially just sends the slider continuously from one side to the other. It's great for interview setups, if you want to have a second angle and you want to add a little bit of movement to it, or you can shoot yourself doing something and you don't want to get bothered with that second angle, so the slider can do its thing while you're doing yours. Great feature. So with this, let's go outside and let's see what this setup here can do. So let's shoot some B-roll. Now, what do I think? Is the Slider Mini worth spending $399 on? And in my opinion, yes, it is. Now, first of all, it's very solidly built. I can really feel it, that this is a product that can last. But most importantly, it's easy to operate, either with your smartphone, like other sliders as well. But if you're on the go and you don't want to fiddle around with your phone, and you just want to whoop this out of your bag and create some cinematic looking panning shots, you can do this with just a tap of that single button here, which makes it super easy. And easy is really what every YouTuber or one man show needs, because it's not overwhelming, it's easy to manage, and I can have this little thing do its thing while I do mine, like for instance speaking to the camera, and it isn't distracting, which is really, really helpful, and it adds to the production value of my videos. Now, as a side note, and especially as a Sony user, because the Sony a7 III doesn't come with native time-lapse modes, the release cable that actually comes with the slider, which is so nice, you know, allows you now to shoot time-lapse and hyperlapse shots with your Sony a7 III. So not only can I create, you know, these smooth sliding shots now, I can also, you know, create hyperlapse and time-lapse videos with the Sony a7 III, thanks to the Slider Mini, which is just fantastic. Now, if you have any questions about the Slider Mini on top of what you've seen in today's video, just leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up because it helps me and that helps the channel grow. And yeah, if you want to see more of these type of videos and tutorials going forward, please subscribe to my channel and hit that, you know, bell icon, 2018, yeah, it's still 2018 style, soon 2019 style. And with that, I'll catch you in my next video, probably with way more sliding shots than I used to. So catch you in the next one.